Hey everybody, Jake here and welcome to The Hobby. Today I have a really interesting video for you guys. We are going to be discussing graded Pokemon cards and whether they're completely stupid or not. I think this is actually kind of fun. What started all this? Well, it started when I was looking at the prices for first edition base set Charizard. If you notice on the screen, there is a gargantuan jump between the PSA 9 and the PSA 10. A PSA 9 first edition base set Charizard is probably as close to immaculate as a PSA 10, they are very, very partially differences. We're talking about the most minute of differences. And I guess my question is, are PSA 9s a little bit underrated? Because at the end of the day, they're pretty much the exact same copy. Are you really willing to spend 270 grand in excess to buy a card that has the slightest of better centering and the slightest less whitening? And I think there's a little bit of psychology in this. I think a lot of people try to avoid PSA 9s or any grade that is below pristine because a 9 means an imperfect card. No matter how close it is to perfect, a 9 means an imperfect card. And we, especially as collectors, we strive for perfection. So that's why if a PSA 10 is available, I think most people are actually willing to pay an exorbitant premium for that 10. And the prices between a 10 and a 9 for a lot of these cards are really outrageous. We're talking about insane gaps for the most minute of differences. And I honestly think a PSA 9 is very, very underrated right now. If you are looking for a card inside of your collection, I highly recommend you pick up a 9 if you cannot afford a 10. And this is very specific, but if the 10 is outside of your budget, don't feel distressed. Don't feel like you have to get the best copy of a card. If you really want a card inside your collection, go for that 9, because let's be honest, we're talking about the most minute of differences. Here I have a PSA 10 stained glass bird, and on my right I have a PSA 9. Now, can anyone tell me what the difference between these two cards are? And I'm sure you're gonna say something like, well, I'm gonna have to look at them really close. I'm gonna have to squint my eyes. I'm gonna have to do some serious inspection to be able to tell the difference between this 9 and this 10. And the 9 is still on my right. So if that is what requires you to know the difference between a 9 and a 10, are you really willing to spend in excess of 10 times the price of a 9 just so that you can get those double digit grades on your card? So this is what I'm talking about right now. And you might be thinking, well, what about other grades, you know? And I'll be honest, and this is just me, but I think like you can even go as low as like a 7 or a 6, and those grades still look fantastic. You really can't tell the difference even at those lower levels. Here we have a PSA 10 and a PSA 9 on my right. Once again, can you guys tell me any differences between these two cards at all? Do you notice any scratch or imperfections on the 9? Probably not. Like if you squint really close, maybe you can find like the tiniest spots of whitening. But there just isn't a lot of issues between a 9 and a 10. So let's go even further. Let's jump the gap. All right. Well, you're saying, well, what if we go lower? Okay. Well, here I have a PSA 6 stained glass bird. So we dropped it by 4 grades from a 10 to a 6. That's a huge jump. So can anyone tell me if there's something wrong with this PSA 6? I'm sure if you look really closely, you might be able to spot some small minute errors, but let's be honest, wow, look at that centering. Really solid centering. I'm not really seeing any real whitening, and I'm sure there's a reason that this card got a PSA 6. I'm not discussing legitimacy of this grade. That's not what I'm discussing at all. I completely believe that the PSA 6 is well deserved. What I'm saying is, at the end of the day, if you're on a tight budget, if you're someone that cannot afford the 10, go for the lower grade. Just get those cards inside of your collection if they are cards that you are willing to chase after, you know. Don't feel like you have to get a 10. I think that's a mindset that too many collectors are stuck in, is that if they don't get a 10, then they won't even collect a card. It's a 10 or a bust for a lot of collectors. Why settle for less than a 10? And I'm gonna be honest with you guys, there's nothing wrong with these cards. There's nothing wrong with this PSA 6. Sure, I can probably find a scratch on it. I'm confident there's a reason it got a 6, but to my naked eye, it's a nice card. This card will look great on display. Who cares if it's a 6? That's the discussion that I'm having right now. So yeah, there we have the PSA 6 next to the PSA 10. And from a distance, especially from any distance, I'll be honest, I can't really tell the difference. If I don't look at the grade, I might think that's a PSA 10. So let's go with some Japanese card. Here we have a PSA 10 Scream Rowlet and a PSA 6. Once again, I can't really tell much of a difference. The two grades are worlds apart, like they're leagues apart, and I'll be honest, I'm not really seeing anything wrong with these two cards. They're both fantastic. If you were to ask me, if I were to remove the labels, if I were to hide them, I'll be honest, I'm not sure you guys can tell which one is a 6 and which one's a 10. And of course, we're not professionals, but we don't have to be. We can enjoy a card just as much as anyone else without having to see its grade. And I'll be honest, if I were to look at the back of these two, I can see a little bit of whitening on the top corner right there of the PSA 10, but I can see the same little whitening on the top of the PSA 6. So looking at the back of these two cards, if I were to, you know, we're swapping them back around, I'm not gonna be able to tell you which one is which. They're pretty darn close right now. And I'm sure there's a reason why the one on the right got a PSA 6. I'm sure of it. I'm sure if I look under a magnifying glass, I'm gonna be able to find a dent or a scratch somewhere on it that made it deserving of the 6. Like I said, I'm not questioning the legitimacy of it. I'm saying if you really want a Scream Rowlet promo inside of your collection, just get the 6 if that's what you can afford. Now, if you truly want a 10, then feel free to spend those extra dollars on the 10. But if you are looking for a card inside of your collection, if you're worried about fakes, then just go for a legitimate card of a slightly lower quality. You're not going to be able to tell the difference. This card is gorgeous on display. I will happily take a set of PSA 6 Scream promos over no set any day of the week. I think this card is fantastic. Anyway, let's go over a couple more examples. Here we have Solgaleo GX PSA 9 and a PSA 10. Can you guys spot the difference? I cannot. Especially between the 9s and the 10s. I think most people are striving way too hard for the 10s and the 9s are way too underrated. I mean, a 10 times gap between the 9 and the 10 is just outrageous to me. There's no reason why there needs to be that level of a gap for these cards. They look gorgeous in any grades. So honestly, yeah, if you are looking to collect some graded Pokemon cards and you want some legitimate ones inside of your collection because you're worried about fakes or whatever, go for a lower grade. I will give you that approval. Definitely do that. So here we have something a little bit more extreme. We have a 1996 super old PSA 10 base set Blastoise. On the right, we have a 5.5 excellent plus condition. This was the lowest one I could find inside of my collection. So, wow. I mean, if you look at the back, I'm sure you can spot whitening. Yeah, if I look at the back, I can see that there's some whitening issue with the PSA 5.5, but that's not the point. If I had these two cards on display, they both look really gorgeous. In fact, I might be more tempted to display the 5.5 just because it's not as expensive. You know, I really don't want to be displaying super expensive cards. You don't really see me displaying any cards that are worth over a couple thousand dollars because it's honestly kind of scary to be displaying cards of that caliber inside of my house even. But yeah, if you are looking for a card, just go with this 5.5. Go for a 4 even. Like, these two cards are both really gorgeous. If you hide the grades, no one's gonna care. I feel like I would be just as happy with either of these cards being displayed inside of my collection. So that's my big ask today. Can you guys let me know, am I crazy on this, or are the gaps in the grades just so outrageous right now with PSA 9s being completely undervalued in the Pokemon hobby. I mean, for a lot of collectors, I feel like it's PSA 10 or bust. If they can't get a PSA 10, most collectors, I feel like, wouldn't even consider a PSA 9. And I was like that at a certain point, and I've recognized the psychology behind it now in having a perfect card. I do want perfection inside of my collection. However, I've become a lot more flexible as a collector. I'm willing to accept those lower grades if it's a card that I want inside of my collection and it's within my budget. We don't have to overspend just to get a PSA 10, because I know, I understand a lot of PSA 10 cards are completely inflated in terms of prices right now. So that's pretty much my rant for today. Let me know if I'm crazy down in the comment section or if I'm making any sense at all. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time.